Did you ever read Viktor Frankl? Viktor Frankl's Man's Search for Meaning? It's a great, great book. Frankl was in a camp in the Holocaust, and the book comes out of that experience. It's about his experience in the human dark side and preserving his human identity in the face of the camp's degradation and violence and suffering and total ripping away of identity. It's a totally great, brilliant book, and now think about it. If there wasn't the Holocaust, there wouldn't be a Man's Search for Meaning. It's not impossible. There are cases where it can enlarge you.
It's not impossible.
Make you more than you were before. More of a complete human being. Like Viktor Frankl. Or that old saying about how whatever doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
We
don't stop and remember nobody's just the victim. And nothing is just negative and just unfair. Almost nothing is like that. What she knows is that the totally most terrible, degrading thing that she ever could have even imagined happening to her has really happened to her now. And she survived. She's still here. And plus now also she knows more about the human condition and suffering and terror and degradation. I mean, all of us will admit suffering and horror are part of being alive and existing, or at least we all pay lip service to knowing it, the human condition. But now she really knows it. I'm not saying she's thrilled about it, but think how much bigger now her view of the world is, how much more broad and deep the big picture is now in her mind.
I get it.
She can understand suffering in a totally different way. Totally terrible things happen. Existence and life break people in all kinds of awful fucking
Dad,
ways all the time.
Back's went okay.
And if she could go back and have a way to stop it, she would, but if you asked her if she could go into her head and forget it or like erase the tape of it happening in her memory, what do you think she'd say?
What do you think she'd say?
Are you so sure what she'd say?
Not using, ever.
That she wishes she never had to, like, structure her mind to deal with it happening to her, to all of a sudden know the world can break you just like that. To know that another human being, these guys, can look at you lying there and in the totally deepest way understand you as a thing. Not a person, a thing. A thing. We think we know all these things about human rights and human dignity and how terrible it is to take away somebody's humanity.
That's what we call somebody's humanity.
But to have it happen to you, see, and now you really know. Now it's not just an idea or a cause to get all knee-jerk about. Have it happen and you get a real taste of the dark side. Not just the idea of darkness, the genuine dark side. And now you know the power of it, the total power. Because if you can really see somebody just as a thing, you can do anything to them. What you used to think of as you, it would rip away all that.
Then what would be left?
That when everything that has any like connection to the you you think you are gets ripped away, and now all that's left is only
what?
What's left? Is there anything left?
Is there anything left?
You're still alive, so what's left is you?
What's that?
What is you mean?
You mean now?
The hardest part of it was now knowing she could think of herself that way too if she wanted.
As a thing.
That it's totally possible to think of yourself not as you or even a person, but just a thing. And it's a very intensive freedom and power in many ways. That now all bets are off and everything's taken away and you can do anything to anybody or even to yourself if you want, because who cares? Because what does it really matter? Because what are you anyway?
Which is just a thing.
She totally knows it's possible to be just a thing, but just like Viktor Frankl, that every minute from then on, minute by minute, if you want, you can choose to be more if you want. You can choose to be a human being and have it mean something.
Let Mr. White go.
Then what would you say? It's like Frankl's thing of learning it's not automatic. How it's a matter of choice to be a human being with sacred rights instead of a thing or a rat, and most people are so smug and knee-jerk and walking around asleep they don't even know it's something you have to actually choose for yourself, that only has meaning when all the like props and stage settings that let you just go around smugly assuming you're not a thing are ripped away and broken, because all of a sudden now the world understands you as a thing. Everybody else thinks you're a rat or a thing, and now it's up to you. You're the only one that can decide if you're more.
I should've done something different. If you just do stuff and nothing happens, what's the point?
That the only one that thinks you're even a person every second is you, and you could stop anytime you wanted and whenever you want go back to just being a thing. What if I said it happened to me? Would that make a difference?